Hello students, today we learn that what is supercharging and why it is done with an IC engine. Okay, supercharging is a process which is generally done with CI engines, compression ignition engine. Okay, and generally in compression ignition engine, diesel fuel is used, so it is employed generally with the diesel engines. Okay, it is employed to improve the efficiency of engine as well as the work output of engine. Okay, so it improves the power per unit weight of the engine, because by a small additional component we can improve the amount of power of the engine by not significantly increasing the amount of weight of engine. So once again, supercharging is a process which is generally done with CI engine just to improve the efficiency and the work output of the engine. Okay, so over here I am showing the indicative diagram of a CI engine. This is the cylinder, okay, this is the piston, connecting rod, flywheel, and these are the inlet and outlet valves. Okay, and I believe that you all know the details of the four stroke CI engine. Okay, just I am revising the same over here. In short, I will revise it. Okay, now what happens, the first stroke of four stroke CI engine is a suction stroke in which the piston moves from TDC to BDC and it sucks fresh air inside. Okay, and suppose this displacement, okay, this is called as engine displacement, the amount of air which is sucked inside by this piston is equals to 200 cc. For example, I am taking here some magnitude just to make the understanding easy. Okay, so this is how the suction stroke ends. Suppose it sucks 200 cc of air inside. Okay, next is the compression stroke, okay, in which that air is compressed. At the end of compression, some amount of diesel is sprayed inside by the help of this fuel injector. Okay, so the diesel goes inside, it catches fire. Okay, by this way heat is added to the system. The next is your working stroke. And at the end of working stroke, the outlet valve opens and the burned gases are expelled out of the system. Okay, so this kind of engine is called as naturally aspirated engine. Okay, means simply the inlet valve opens, the piston sucks the air inside. Okay, it compresses it and diesel is added. Okay, diesel burns, by this way heat is added, then work is done and ultimately exhaust. Okay, so it is called as naturally aspirated engine. Now what happens in supercharging? Over the inlet valve, one more component, that is a supercharger, is connected. You can see it is a sort of air compressor. Okay, now what is its job? When suction stroke happens, when suction stroke executes, what happens? Piston moves from TDC to BDC. Okay, so normally it sucks the air inside. Okay, but over here what is happening? A compressor more is implanted over the inlet valve. So what happens? That when the piston moves from TDC to BDC, then it sucks the air inside, as well as this compressor also forces the air to go inside. Both the things are happening. The piston is sucking the air inside, as well as compressor is also forcing more air to go inside. So instead of 200 cc, okay, over here in naturally aspirated engine, in case the displacement of this piston is 200 cc, it is sucking 200 cc of air inside. Okay, but in case we are implanting a supercharger, then while suction stroke, by this forceful pushing of air inside, 100 cc more is entering inside. Over here these magnitudes are just for making you understand. Means you can suppose it that since air is pulled as well as pushed also, so more amount of air is going inside. So suppose it is 300 cc. okay, now when 200 cc of air is sucked inside, then when compression stroke executes, ultimately suppose it can burn 1 milligram of diesel. But in case in the same engine, if 300 cc of air is sucked inside and further it is compressed, so you can see that almost 50% of more air has been entered inside. So 50% of more diesel can be burned, that could be 1.5 milligrams of diesel. So by this way 50% more heat is developed, so more work done will be developed over the piston and in turn over the crankshaft. Okay, so this supercharger is nothing but a sort of centrifugal compressor. It sucks the air from the atmosphere, and whenever this inlet valve opens and piston pulls the air inside, then it forcefully pushes some more amount of air to go inside. So by this way, when more air goes inside, then more diesel or more fuel can be burned, more heat can be developed, and more work output can be obtained. The weight of this supercharger, this extra component, is not very high. Okay, so in turn, the amount of power developed by this engine divided by the total weight of this entire system is higher than that of in case we are not using any supercharger, and then whatever the amount of power developed over the crankshaft, and dividing it by the weight of the engine. Okay, so by this way power by weight ratio also improves. Okay, so this is what the job of supercharger. So hope you would have understood by this small story how the supercharger works and what is its significance. Thank you.